Thank you, Deputy First Minister. That concludes topical questions. And the next item of business will be an urgent question. And if a member wishes to ask a supplementary, they should press the request to speak button during, during the question or enter the letters RTS in the chat function. I call Maurice Golden.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. To ask the Scottish Government what its response is to last night's disorder in Dundee, including what action it is taking to prevent it continuing and support the community to aid clean-up efforts.
Cabinet Secretary Keith Brown.
The disorder in Dundee last night was appalling and wholly unacceptable. The impact on the community and indeed on emergency services will have been, of course, extremely distressing. I know that Police Scotland, the SFRS and local authorities have been making great efforts to prevent and to respond effectively to any disorder in the run-up to Bonfire Night, including through the police's Operation Moonbeam. We will be engaging further with these bodies and others to learn lessons and provide what further support we can.
Maurice Golden.
I thank the Cabinet Secretary for that answer, and I agree the violent scenes in Dundee last night were appalling. Fireworks exploding near police, bricks hurled at cars, and even a school attacked. I want to thank our emergency services for their bravery responding and for today's update from Police Scotland, confirming action to prevent further violence and an ongoing investigation to catch those responsible. And there must be consequences for those responsible. So can the Cabinet Secretary provide detail on what resources it is providing to assist local police and what assurance residents have that the perpetrators will be identified and punished?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, I agree with much of what Maurice Golden has said, but he will also know that these matters, the operational matters in terms of the investigations and what further action is taken, are matters for the police. But I can provide the assurance those investigations are ongoing just now with the police. They themselves have said to me in a meeting I had with them earlier on today that they find the recent legislation passed by this Parliament in relation to fireworks, the Fireworks Act, as hugely helpful. So they are bolstered by that legislative backstop. They've also given me assurances around proposed plans for this coming weekend. I should say from those that had first-hand experience of what happened last night, they were very grateful for the rapid deployment of additional police officers from elsewhere to bolster the efforts of local police officers. And that, of course, will be factored into the police's response over the course of the next weekend, in particular the 4th and 5th of November, which traditionally, as a member will be aware, can be at a time when there is some level of additional activity, especially around fireworks.
Maurice Golden.
The Cabinet Secretary mentioned the new fireworks licensing scheme. And although it's not in place yet, one flaw is that those convicted of antisocial behaviour do not need to disclose this when applying for a fireworks licence. Will the Cabinet Secretary admit the SNP mistake on this and review the decision in light of last night's events?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, this Parliament passed that Act, and I support the provisions of that Act. And the member, I'm not saying deliberately, but may have jumped over the fact that two vital provisions of that Act are in force now. So in terms of proxy buying for young children, and also crucially in terms of the aggravating factor, if somebody is found guilty, the court is now, as of the passing of that Act, required to take that into account in terms of any disposal. The member's right to say there are other parts of the Act which have yet to come into force, as was said at the time of the passing of that Act, and those will be brought into force according to the timescales that we have. But the important point, I think, is to, as the member has done, support the police in their activities, to support them in what they intend to do over the course of the weekend, and to encourage others. I've mentioned the SFRS, obviously, also the local council, to do what they can to help the police, so that Dundee does not have to experience what we saw last night again.
I have three members seeking to ask a supplementary. I will intend to take each of them. Supplementary, Joe Fitzpatrick.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. As constituency member and a resident of the area, I want to share my shock at the scenes last night, which were terrifying for those in the immediate area. We need to do everything we can to ensure that this is not repeated. I welcome the Cabinet Secretary and Police Scotland's assurances around increased police presence in the area, and I want to put on record my thanks to police officers who attended and were put in harm's way due to due to the reckless actions of a small minority. This morning, I reached out to Asda, who have agreed to withdraw fireworks from sale on all three of their Dundee stores, including in Kirkton. Will the Cabinet Secretary join me in calling for other retailers to follow suit and take voluntary action while we await the full commencement of the Fireworks and Pyrotechnic Article Scotland Act?
Cabinet Secretary.
Can I say, first of all, in relation to the member's reference to how frightening this was, there was one injury last night, and that was to a police officer from shards of glass through a brick being put through a police vehicle. And that shows how serious the situation was, and the member's quite right to say how terrifying that can be for local residents. I welcome very much the news that Asda have agreed to withdraw fireworks from sale in local stores, and would commend the local member for the activity that he's undertaken. Of course, the decision on whether to withdraw legally available products is one for the supermarkets involved. But I would say to the member that the police themselves have been very pleased to see the action that Asda have taken. And just to say, in relation to the rest of the Fireworks Act, programme of work is underway to make sure that the rest of that Act is implemented. We have engaged with the Scottish Retail Consortium, which will be important given the request that the member has just made, as well as the Scottish Grocers Federation. And the other aspects, the licensing system, the restricted days of supply and use provisions and the firework control zones, are all being taken forward by this Parliament. But the people most responsible, and it was those that carried out these acts that are responsible, will now have to face the consequences before a court. And in doing so, they will face the aggravating factor which the court will be obliged to take into place. And I would hope that the courts will make the full force of the law come down on those people that have subjected local people to the experience they had to go through last night.
Supplementary, Michael Mara.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and I share the sentiments around the chamber. The events of yesterday evening were absolutely disgraceful. I welcome Police Scotland's urgent pursuit of the perpetrators. I can confirm to the Cabinet Secretary that, having spoken to Tesco this afternoon myself, that they have now confirmed that they will cease sales. Would the Cabinet Secretary join in the calls from local politicians that all retailers should cease sales on a voluntary basis to increase the confidence of local people that there will not be repetitions this weekend? Obviously, public displays have recently been cut by the City Council. Can he also give us any information on additional resources that can be brought from the Fire Service and Police around Scotland to ensure that the public have confidence for this weekend?
Cabinet Secretary.
Can I thank the member for the action that he's taken? This may develop into a pattern. We've got Asda, we've now got Tesco, perhaps we can go further. I would say that it's different for different retailers. You'll be aware that some small retailers, it can be a large part of their income. So I would just say what I have said already, that I welcome the action that both the member's taken and Joe Fitzpatrick, as the local member, has taken, and also point out the extent to which the police are very pleased to see the action that's been taken. In relation to what he asks of me, in relation to further information about the police plans for this weekend, I understand why the member is interested. Happy to speak to him with more information, perhaps offline, but I don't want to arm others, if you like, by putting in the public domain some information that might not be useful. But other than to say that the resources that will be available in Dundee this weekend are being augmented in light of the actions that happened last night. And beyond that, as I say, happy to have a further conversation with the member.
And supplementary, Jamie Green.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. The reality is, though, is that prosecution rates for firearms-related offences is relatively low. Can we have some reassurance that the recent legislation that we passed will actually be enforced this time? But it also, can I ask the Cabinet Secretary, does he have any information about the fireworks that were used as weapons, were sourced legally in the retail environment, which we just spoke about, illegally through the use of proxy purchasing for minors, or illicitly on the black market?
Cabinet Secretary.
Can I say to the member's latter point, that will be something that's currently a subject of investigation by the police, as he would understand. And I would say that any information that comes to me that I'm able to pass on in order to respond to the specific points there, I'm happy to do that when that information becomes available. I do think that the action that's been taken by the police is the correct action. Also, in relation to prosecutions, the disposals at court, the member knows, I know that he knows this, I am not able to direct the police in their investigations, neither am I able to direct the courts as to how they deal with those investigations. But he said what he said, it's on the official report, and I'm sure that these agencies will look at that.